This is Allium Tricoccum, i.e. also known as ramps in the south. Up here in New York, they're leeks, and that's a ethnobotanical cultural background kind of thing. It has a rhizome with lacy roots. It actually does not have a bulb, but we call it a bulb because it does have a protrusion down here, which slides into the petiole. It characteristic has a pink petiole that then goes into, on average, two leaves, but in this case, three leaves. And I have seen one plant that had four leaves. Most people harvest the whole plant. So they dig it up, they cut it up, and then they harvest that, right? And then they take this protective sheath off of it, and then they eat it. And the best way to eat a ramp is in the woods, like we are this morning, listening for turkeys. They say it's a cross between a garlic and a scallion, right? So it's a really garlicky, but as Ken Mudge was saying, it's really peppery too. So it's a mix between your garden onion, your scallion, and garlic. Really has a strong aftertaste that comes in, kicks in like a minute or so after you've indulged. You could go from virtually wild to segment it to more managing it, helping moving the plants around a little bit and encouraging the plants, to then really intensive forest farming where you're setting up beds, planting bulbs or planting seed preferably. So you could take something like this, and I could envision an area like this where you actually have beds, raised beds, in strategically put into this landscape where we're planting ramps, right? And it could be integrated into a patch like this. I don't have a lot of land, access to land, but I've got a little patch of ramps like this. I can make it work for me.
You're managing
managing a wild patch. Right. I'm enhancing the wild patch through farming techniques, right? But I'm doing it under a forest, i.e. forest farming.